The 15-Point Plan is part of the Win Make Give podcast network.
Welcome to the 15-Point Plan podcast. Chad Hyams here, joined by my co-host, the Ragnarian herself, Jillene Snell. Yes, that's a word, a Ragnarian.
Yes, and I found that out after we finished this race, Ragnar, because it's on the back of all of our medals. When you put the 12 together from the 12 runners, each person has a little piece of it.
That's right.
And then you put it together and there's the word.
So, Jillene, we've been talking about it. We posted about it in our Facebook group. Hopefully you've joined us, facebook.com/group/winmakegive, which is the network that we're posting in. We've talked about this Ragnar race. We even went so far as to interview one of the founders back in episode 18.
We did.
Of the 15-Point Plan. So, folks, scroll back, hear from Tanner Bell some fantastic information about how this came around. Jillene, we ran a Ragnar race recently, very, very recently. A
couple days ago, actually. A
couple days ago. We're still recovering even from it. Let's talk a little bit about it and share with the audience because they've been a part of the journey with us. Tell me a little bit first. Describe the Ragnar race for anybody who maybe doesn't know what it is or didn't hear the episode with Tanner. Give us the quick overview of what is a Ragnar race.
So this particular one is a 200-mile relay, and it's held actually in all parts of in many parts of the world. But we did the one in, it's called Northwest Passage. It goes from the Canadian border all the way to an island, to the very end of the island, and you pass off to your teammates. There's an ultra you can do with six teammates, but the one that we did was with 12. So the average runner is going to run between 18 to 20 miles, and they're separated by two what we call vans, like literal vans of people where you have six people plus a driver. So this is definitely a team experience. Like when you think of athleticism and a lot of what we do and some challenges we take on physically, they're often solo. Right? Mm-hmm. You know, a half marathon is technically solo.
Yes.
No one's depending on you to get to the finish line. It's all you, baby.
Right.
And so this is different with Ragnar, where it's really a team event. And so I know I'm excited to talk with you about how your experience with that was.
Well, Ragnar was tons of fun. Jillene summed it up very nicely. I've done some homework on Ragnar and noticed that we chose the hilliest course out there. They have like almost no elevation on the East Coast, Ragnar.
Can we do that one next?
Yes, absolutely. So before we even get into it, I want to give a huge shout out to our Ragnar Win Make Give team that came together. Many of them hopefully listening to the podcast. And if not, maybe you want to let your friends know. But if I go through the vans in order of how we ran them, let's see if I can do it in order. So Jillene, you were leg one. My wife Nita was leg two. We had Penny was running leg three. Annette ran leg four. I had the pleasure of running leg five. And Nate came and joined us. Nate Smoyer came and joined us for leg six. And we had the pleasure of Scott driving us in our van. Folks, you have to earn the driver. That's one of those things. Now, if we went over to van number two, let's see. Jen Lampe started van two for us. I believe she handed it to Ryan, who was there for leg seven or eight, I guess that would be. Nine, I think, was Diane. 10, I'm believing, might have been Maddie. 11, I think, was Kendall. And then 12 was Jennifer to finish it up. And they had Matt driving their van. Wow. So there's just a shout out to our Win Make Give team.
Holy crow, you have a good memory.
And well, it's the job of the captain of the team.
I was just going to say, Chad was the captain of the team. And it's really crucial to have someone that is actually taking ownership of the event because it's a bit of organization. So you want someone who's going to keep, you know, 12, 13, 14 people on track.
In our case, yes, with those two extra drivers.
And so having start with the captain, you know, the captain gets everyone signed up for the event and make sure everyone's committed and know that there will be life that happens in between the time that you sign up for it and the time that you run it. So you need a couple backup runners in place.
Yeah, two of our runners were actually not original members of the Win Make Give team, that we had people who had injuries or family emergencies or something come up. So yeah, had to be prepared for that and being ready to deal with situations like that. But ended up with a fantastic team. Jillene, we came in 88th out of 192 in our category, which was just general runners.
Woohoo!
Right, yeah. So we were in the top half.
Yes.
So I'm pretty proud of the team that we came in the top half. I figured out the math. You had to average a 7-minute mile to do it in under one day.
Gosh, that's amazing.
If everybody ran a 7-minute mile or faster, we could have done it in one day. We didn't get that accomplished. It took us about 33 hours, but that was actually almost a full hour less than we were targeted to complete that in.
Okay.
We were targeted to take 50 minutes or so longer than we actually did. So, Jillene, it might hurt a little to take you back there. Your legs might tighten up just by talking about it. But tell me, what's the memory you're going to take away from completing this Ragnar experience?
Okay, it's hands down just this community that you have with your people there. Because people have been, you know, every runner had been training leading up to it. Mm-hmm. And then you get there and you're in it together. You're in it with, like, sometimes you're deprived of food, sleep, sure, your natural patterns and rituals in your life.
Yep.
And you're not in that regular routine. You're thrown off, right? You're running in the middle of nowhere sometimes.
Yep.
But your team, and especially our team, the Win, Make, Give team, was so on point at just like showing up even when they were tired. Like, we'd get ourselves out of the van in the heat and go encourage our teammates on. And I know we were pouring water over Penny at one moment,
yep,
as she was running like an 8.5-mile leg. By the way, this is one of my favorite memories because Penny is about, I think, 66 years old.
That's what she said.
And she runs like 1 to 2 half marathons a year. This was, I think, one of her hardest runs. She ran about 18-ish miles, 18, 19 miles. But she was running most of that uphill and a lot of it in the heat. And boy, she really demonstrated like this tenacity that inspired me personally. And I said, like, you know, I'm a bit younger and I sometimes complain at how my body feels when I'm training. And it just sort of blew away all of my excuses and said, like, I can do this.
Sure.
So not only were the people, you know, in the van following along, encouraging those out on the road, but then there's Penny encouraging me from the road.
Yeah, absolutely. She was a great example to have on our team and a great person. Mine, while I was proud of everybody and it was wonderful to watch everybody, I have never done a midnight run before. There's no reason to. I mean, I go to sleep at 8 o'clock at night.
That's right.
Why would I ever want to
chat after 8 p.m.?
You're not getting an answer. Why would I ever want to do a midnight run? Now, I've woken up early and gotten up at 4 o'clock and just gone out and run. And I've done nighttime runs, but to me, that'll be 7, 8 o'clock at night, maybe if I'm pushing for something. One of my legs came at 11 p.m. at night, and it was cold. And it was dark.
It was. There was no street lights.
Nothing. I was running through farmland somewhere. I still don't even know really where I was. I just know I was somewhere on the course. I was running farmland with nothing except a headlight and the light of the runner that was in front of me or the light of a runner behind me.
Mm-hmm.
And it was just such an amazing experience. And Nate told me even before I got there, he had done this before. He said, your favorite run is going to be the nighttime run.
I didn't get one of those on this Ragnar, but I remember doing it before, and it is really special and unique. It's the thing you think you're going to hate the most, but you end up loving like you and Nate experienced.
Yeah, it was that solitude that comes with it and all the stars that are above you. Okay, so that's going to be a memory you're going to take. How about a lesson that you learned during this? As you said, rituals were broken. Folks, I won't tell you the truth about Jillene at 5 a.m. when she wants just 10 more minutes of sleep, right? We were in complete disarray from what our normal lives are like and having to run and run and run and then sit and sit and sit and run and sit. What's the lesson that you learned from this, Jillene?
Well, you know, how important relationships are truly, and being able to be there for people when you're not feeling your best. Now, I think this Ragnar is probably one of the best I've ever had. I felt really great even when we had lack of sleep, when, mm-hmm, you know, I was being woken up in the middle of the night by my teammates, wink, wink. But, you know, I think it was more about just being able to be there for each other and being able to take that to other areas of life, but also the Russell Wilson, quarterback of the Seahawks, of course, he has this quote that says, the separation is in the preparation.
Okay.
And when I was training, you know, in my head, I would think, I have to run these long runs in order to properly train. In reality, what I needed to be doing more of was consistent runs, even if it was less miles. And that would have been the preparation that I needed to really do it well. And thankfully, by the time I got there, I had sort of keyed into that and started running more consistently so that I had that compound effect. Because it wasn't necessarily about massive numbers of miles. It was, again, just doing it every day, every other day. And so that was a big lesson for me. Darren Hardy says, the accomplishment of any goal is in the progressive accumulation or compound effect of small steps, in this case, literally, taken consistently over time.
Well, steps weren't that small. Just to be clear, the steps that we were running weren't that small. You know, Jillene, I was going to say, we didn't prep this in advance. I just said, Jillene, let's go. Let's talk about it. Right? Mine was preparation. It's that 7 habits of highly successful people. Number one is being proactive, not reactive. And it was that being proactive in advance that I can actually do anything. I really didn't question the mileage because it wasn't even a full marathon that I ended up running. I took 22 miles of the run is how it broke down. So it wasn't even a full marathon that I ran. And it was never more than 8 miles at a time that I had to run. Yet it was, I had never done run 3 times within a 33-hour period of length like that.
And one in the middle of the night.
Right. And it was the preparation that had gone into it of running almost every day, the weeks leading up to it, to being trained, that it's just helped me realize that I can do anything if I do the preparation that's required to plan for it. So,
I
folks,
think we have a theme here.
Yeah, absolutely. We didn't talk about this, but absolutely, folks, if you want to do anything, I don't care whether that's a Ragnar, whether that's something else in your life, whether that's just business success, whether that's marriage, whether that's whatever it is, how much are you preparing in advance to take on? I think that's the lesson I'll take away from this. So, Jillene, we've got audience members and they're out there and maybe they want to ask some questions to you. And one question would be, should I? Can I? Right. What would you say to our audience members who are thinking, should I, can I, in the sense of a Ragnar?
Well, first I would ask, like, are you looking to achieve something? Are you looking for a milestone? And in this case, you get a tangible result. You get to the finish line, you get a medal, you get to celebrate, and that's really fun. It's a start to finish sort of process. And so if someone's looking for that, I think Ragnar is a really good way to do it and do it with a team of people versus it being sort of this solo experience. And, you know, my medal that I got from Ragnar, everyone's had a different phrase on the back.
Yes.
And my phrase said, take the hard way out.
Oh, nice.
And so I think if you feel like you're in this place where you're just comfortable and kind of just cruising, you're like, yeah, life is good. I'm cruising. I don't feel super challenged. Do something hard. And that was actually one of my motivations for signing up for it, because honestly, it wasn't just the 36-hour event was that was the hardest part. It was also the training leading up to it that was probably the hardest part.
Sure.
And all of that, taking the hard way out, I got back and I said, like, Chad, I can do hard things, right? And that translated to like some of my work projects that I have or some mountains that I need to climb in my personal life. Like, I can do hard things. And so I think even if you don't love running, that this might be just what you need.
Yeah, and there are different legs in there. So we had some runners that didn't have to run as far as others. Some people ran a total of like 12 miles or something like that. So you don't have to sit there and say, oh my gosh, I don't want to have to run 20 miles. I can't do it.
Fair.
Okay. There are shorter legs. You can join up with a group or make sure that your group gives you the opportunity to be the runner who picks the least amount of miles maybe that's in that van. It's absolutely something worth taking on for everybody that's out there. Jillene is right. It is a community. You will never feel alone. Even if you're running that midnight run like I had the pleasure of running, there are other people that are always still talking to you as they go by. There are vans waving at you. We recognized probably the same groups again and again and again at the exchange point. You started to recognize some people or some groups. You start to create community out there on the field with people who aren't just in your van. So it is a fun experience if you're looking to have one. So Jillene, you can do hard things. So what's next?
Yeah, good question. Well, I don't have really any aspirations to climb Mount Everest. I think I saw that in a Facebook post of yours, Chad.
Yep.
You know, now that you have momentum, like I've done the training, done the long run, maybe run another half marathon and sign up for that just so I have something that keeps me exercising every day. You know, following the 15-point plan every single day, one of those check marks is to exercise a minimum of 20 minutes a day.
Yes, get
which
your movement.
I typically do, right? And sometimes I need a little bit more because I don't want to just coast. So it's picking something like a half marathon in a fun place. I'm thinking like pick a half marathon in another state just to travel and go and do that, maybe somewhere without hills.
So what Chad? State comes to mind, Jillene?
What state? Probably not a hot state.
Okay.
I don't know, East Coast. I got an invite to New Hampshire.
Okay. So Jillene, sitting here, why don't you Google that? See what half marathons are coming up in here. Let's get a commitment from you.
Oh, don't
here
do this on the air.
So that we have this and everybody knows that Jillene's committed. Because right now, while you have the high of Ragnar is when you're most likely to commit to something else to challenge yourself.
That's true. And how about this? Why doesn't the audience reach out to me and tell me where I should go, that they're going to do it with me? Because I want to do something with another person or a team of people.
All right. So those of you listening out there, Jillene has said East Coast, probably Northeast, because she doesn't want to go too hot. So she's not talking down in Florida or anywhere down on that side of the country. If you've got a half marathon, I saw some beautiful Ragnar races on that side of the country. Maybe Jillene is your person and you should get a commitment out of her while it's high in her thoughts. We'll be putting a post in the Facebook group, facebook.com/group/winmakegive, where you can come and encourage and challenge Jillene to join you on something that's going to bring that.
We need to shift this, Chad.
Sure.
This
I've
is
already decided what's
for,
next
I need
for
to know,
me.
I need to know what's next for
that's
you.
That's easy. Nita and I have already agreed that we are intending to do the 29029 Everesting Challenge. So we're not going to actually go to Mount Everest.
Okay.
And climb it. But there is a company here in the United States called 29029, which is the elevation of Everest, Everesting.com. And they do Everesting events. So they give you 36 hours to go up a mountain, come down the gondola, and go right back up the mountain. And you're going to have to do, depending on the mountain that the event is at, 13 to 19 times that you have to scale whatever mountain they are climbing with a base camp at the bottom, and you have a 36-hour challenge to make it to 29,029 feet and accomplish what would be climbing Mount Everest. So Nita and I have already decided that in 2022, because the 2021 events are already sold out, we will be taking that challenge on. So you are more than welcome to hold me to it, audience, and you are more than welcome to follow along in our Facebook group as I share the journey.
That is some great accountability. And it's an organized event, right?
Yes. It's another organized event, another community event. You can go on your own. You can go in pairs. You could get a whole group together, but the tents hold two people. And it becomes a community of people climbing a mountain multiple times to be able to climb as high as if you climbed Everest.
That sounds great.
So it'll be a start. Maybe Mount Everest one day, yet this will be our step towards that.
Maybe a little warmer version of it, right?
Amen. Although the Vermont event gets pretty darn cold from what I've seen tracking their information. Folks, we want you to understand, like Jillene said, you can do hard things. Like her medal told her, right? What was it? Take the hard way out?
Take the hard way out.
Take the hard way out. Folks, stop looking for the easy path. Anybody can find the easy path. We want to challenge you here at the 15-point plan. Find the hard way out, because when you come out, you're going to be so much happier for going through it the hard way. We hope that you are subscribing. We hope that you are sharing the podcast, and we hope that you enjoyed our Ragnar experience, and maybe next year there's one for you. Don't hesitate to reach out to us and let us know how we can help encourage, support, and how the 15-point plan can help you get there. Until our next episode, we hope this upped your energy level and takes you to the next level.